his lover boy, who were in Toronto a while ago playing at the music hall.
I see you watching, you watch your life. Me and 20 others, we've been watching you all night. Even though I saw you first, I'm still last in line. I can see from here, you're not the loving kind. The way you treat the boys is a disgrace. It's so sad to see a pretty face. Present, 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 present. Cows are very, very present, present. Cows are very, very present, present.
It's been less than 2 years since Loverboy were put together, and already they've had a gold album, two top 30 singles, and were nominated for Most Promising Group at this year's Junos. Those are pretty big accomplishments for a new band, but they don't surprise lead singer Mike Reno, who makes no bones about the fact Loverboy are out to capture the market.
Loverboy is put together on the assumption of success. We had a success theory planned. Gave it a year, and if we happen to see some of the success, We thought it would be okay, business and all that, you know. It's mostly business in this.
With almost 50 songs in their repertoire, Loverboy can pick and choose which ones to release at what time to make best use of their hit potential. I asked them if this wasn't being calculating in their approach.
Yeah, definitely. But it's not like we planned out this whole trip. There's only a certain amount of strategy that you can do. We originally said when we got together, After our first few gigs, we've been in so many bands that have gotten the trucks and gotten the PAs, and everyone signed on the dotted line for these huge bank loans, and everyone got burnt. Everyone's been burnt a million times by that. So we just said, why do that? Why go that route? And you get trapped in the bar scene. Just let's go for the record contract and rent stuff and live like dogs for a while. Get the contract, and that's what we did. We played the bars for about a month, got the people down to see us, signed the contract, did the album. Bang. Put the album out in the summertime.
We spend our time and money writing songs and preparing a proper business tactic to enter this business.
Why write songs that you think are just socially acceptable and acceptable to the commercial masses instead of writing something that, say, you like and that you want to hear, something that you feel is an accomplishment?
Are you saying we're selling out now?
No, I'm not saying that.
I like this stuff.
Not in a direct way.
I like this stuff.
It's just a matter of tuning in to what people like, you know, and then trying, like listening to the Cars and stuff like that, and then going, well, what's so hot about that? Why did that sell 17 million zillion albums? And not actually taking that structure and putting it into our own thing, but just sort of trying to tune in to what they have that makes them so universally acceptable, you know?
With that attitude, people are going to start saying, okay, business machine, can't take them seriously. They're only in it for the money. What are you going to say to that?
I'm just going to say, if people believe that there's a group practicing in the garage somewhere, and somebody walks by and hears them, and then next week they're superstars, if they believe that whole syndrome, then that's a big fantasy, right? And if they want to know the truth about it all, if you want to succeed in something, if it's selling real estate, running a corporation, running a laundromat, or anything, you got to make some plans. That's all we're doing.
Whatever you want to call it, selling out, calculating their success, it's working. Loverboy have directed themselves at the teenage heavy pop market and are cashing in. In the long run, it may not leave their conscience clear, but it'll fill their bank account.